Today I'm going to show you how to connect to your Raspberry Pi remotely. By the end of this video, you'll be able to connect to your device from anywhere in the world, including from your iPhone or Android. All of that coming up next. The program we're going to use to set up a remote connection is called VNC, which is actually a generic term for virtual network computing. Or, so I'm told by Google. The great thing is that if you have a Raspberry Pi with Rasbian Jessie or newer, then you have VNC already installed on your device. It just needs to be activated. So, let's get started. First, you'll need to boot up your Raspberry Pi and open up the command prompt. Run the following commands to make sure you have the latest version. Sudo apt-get update. Sudo apt-get install Real VNC-VNC-server. This is going to tell you whether you have the latest version, or update it if you don't. Okay, so now let's run this command, sudo raspi-config. Navigate to the interfacing options, NVC, and select yes. Next, run the command hostname-i. Make sure I is uppercase. This is going to give you the IP addresses that you can use to connect to your computer, so you're going to want to write these down. From now on, VNC server will automatically start up every time you boot up your Raspberry Pi. Now what we need to do is set up the remote computer. You're going to need to download the VNC viewer on the computer that you want to control from. There are two ways to connect. The first is a direct connection, and the second is a cloud connection. I'm going to show you both. So first, navigate to the download page for VNC Viewer, and I'll post the link in the video description. After you download the file, double-click to install, and then go ahead and click through until everything is installed. Next, you're going to navigate to your start menu and click on VNC Viewer. Okay, let's start a direct connection. Now, a direct connection is good if you want to connect to a device on your local network, and this kind of connection will only work if you are on your home network. When the application opens up, enter the IP address that you wrote down from before in the address bar, and then click Enter. You'll be prompted to enter your username and password that you've set up. If you haven't set up a customized username and password, it's going to be Pi and then Raspberry. Click OK to log in, and now you've successfully remote logged into the computer using a direct IP connection. Alright, let's look at a cloud connection. Now this is going to be good if you want to connect to a device from anywhere in the world, including from your Android or iPhone device. All you'll need to do is to install the app from the App Store and log in using the cloud account that we're about to set up. Go ahead and close your screen and you'll be back at the main application screen. Now click on Sign In, and then click Don't have an account. This is going to set up a free secure cloud account that you can use to log in to your computer from anywhere. I'm going to go ahead and set up a dummy account using a throwaway email I created for this. So enter a password, your first name and last name, and then click all the boxes, choose a country, then click sign up. Now you're going to need to navigate to your email and click the link inside to activate your account. Now that your account is activated, you can sign in to the VNC Viewer application with your login and password. Next, you're going to get yet another email, and this is just to verify that you've signed in to a particular computer. Click the link in that email, and then you can continue signing in to the application. Next, from your Raspberry Pi device, you'll need to add your new account license. So click on the VNC icon on the upper right-hand corner of the screen, and then click on the box with the three bars. Then click Licensing. From here, enter your username and password, then click Sign In. Next, click the free subscription at the bottom of the screen, then click Next. You're now going to give this Raspberry Pi a nickname, and this is the name that's going to show up on the list of devices that you can log into with your cloud account, and it's going to show up in your home group. After you pick a name, click on Apply. Now you can close out of everything, and then open up the application again. Now when you sign in, you'll see on the left-hand side a home group. The IP addresses on the right are the direct connections that I've used, and they will only work inside my home network. However, if I click on my home group, you'll see the device that was named, and I can now connect to it from anywhere. So double-click on the device. You'll need to enter your username and password. And now you're ready to go. That, my friends, is how you can remotely control your Raspberry Pi either locally or from anywhere using a cloud account. If you enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and make sure you subscribe. Check out some of these other cool videos. Talk to you later.